For today's video, we'll be taking a look at a motherboard from Gigabyte that sports the new range-topping AMD X870E chipset, the Gigabyte X870E AORUS Pro Ice. Sporting support for the latest Ryzen 9000 series of processors, as well as the Ryzen 8000 series of APUs, and the older Ryzen 7000 series of CPUs, we'll be taking a closer look at the specs of this board to see if it's any good. Let's get started. To recap, AMD launched its Zen 5 Ryzen 9000 series of processors a couple of weeks back in August 2024, and it'd be par for the course for new processors to be launched alongside new chipsets and new motherboards. For some reason, AMD's chosen to launch its new 800 series chipsets more than a month after the launch of its Ryzen 9000 CPUs, starting first with the higher-end X870 series. The more budget-friendly B800 series of chipsets are rumoured to launch only sometime in early 2025. As per the table on the screen, which was taken from AMD's website, the X870E and X870 offer minimal differences over the X670E and the X670, which they replace, where the key differences lie in faster DDR5 memory support and USB 4 support. All boards with the X870E and X870 chipsets come with USB 4 support as standard. To get in on the launch excitement, we'll be taking a look at the Gigabyte X870E AORUS Pro Ice that, as its name implies, sports the X870E chipset and sits within the AORUS series of gaming-oriented motherboard offerings at the higher end, where it places above the gaming, Eagle, and ultra-durable series of motherboard offerings by Gigabyte. As a X870E motherboard that is targeted at white-colored PC builds, the X870E AORUS Pro Ice comes in a box that sports a white and black colorway with the AORUS Eagle motif emblazoned on the front. Moving over to the rear of the box, we get the usual summary of specs for this board. We'll take a closer look at these specs later on in this video. On a side note, if you're new to the ALKtech channel, do consider subscribing so as to keep up to date with the latest product releases in the PC hardware world. With that, let's have a look at the contents of the box by setting aside the board for the moment. First up, we get a Wi-Fi antenna in white that comes with the new Wi-Fi Easy Plug connector. We do also get two SATA 3 cables, and these are accompanied by a noise detection cable. We do also get a nice quality of life feature called G-Connector that simplifies the process of hooking your PC's front panel connectors to the motherboard. We do also get a metal AORUS case badge right here, a regulatory information leaflet, a multilingual installation guide, as well as a sheet of AORUS stickers. Onto the board itself, we see that Gigabyte has gone for a full silver and white aesthetic. Even the various plastic headers and connectors on the board are colored in white, making this board really suitable for you folks out there who are intending to build a fully white colored AMD AM5 PC. As can be seen, the board comes with an integrated I/O shield design and has large silver heat sinks all around. Over on the rear of the board, we see that the PCB is colored in grey with some motifs for added visual interest. A nice touch, I must say, in spite of the fact that most of these motifs will likely never see the light of day inside of a PC case. RGB junkies will be pleased to note that the board comes with built-in RGB LEDs that can be found on the integrated I/O shield cover, like so. As well as around the chipset heatsink area. The VRM heatsinks for this board are pretty decently sized, and Gigabyte has included 16+2+2 power stages with 80 amp power phases. The X870E chipset has a dual chip design, and the SID chips sit beneath this large passive heatsink right here. for M.2 drive cooling, Gigabyte has got you covered with M.2 drive heatsinks for all four M.2 drive slots that this board comes with. For memory support, the X870E AORUS Pro Ice comes with four DDR5 slots that, as of the time of publishing this video, comes with support for up to 256GB of RAM and the DDR5 8000 standard when overclocked, with what Gigabyte terms memory UD slots that come with stainless steel shields for better signal integrity and slot durability. Naturally, the board also supports AMD's Expo technology, which are basically built-in overclocking profiles for DDR5 memory. In terms of front panel USB connectivity, we get a USB 3.2 Gen 2x2 Type-C front panel header next to the RAM slots and on the bottom edge of the board. Two USB 3.2 Gen 1 Type-A front panel headers, with each header providing for up to two USB 3.2 Gen 1 Type-A ports for a total of four ports. To round things off, we do also get two USB 2.0 front panel headers, with each header providing support for two USB 2.0 Type-A ports for a total of four ports. Some interesting features to highlight. Back at the top of the motherboard, we get a start button that allows end users to power on the PC. A reset button, also termed a multi-key button by Gigabyte, that can be reprogrammed from within the BIOS to serve other purposes. A reset header that can be hooked up to the front panel reset button of a PC case. A debug LED that can help with in-depth troubleshooting of PC issues, as well as a set of status LEDs that can help with troubleshooting PC startup issues. We do also get two onboard temperature sensor headers that can be hooked up to optional thermistor cables to monitor the temperature of components within your PC case, as well as an onboard HDMI 1.4 port right here that forms part of a feature that Gigabyte calls Sensor Panel Link. Now, Sensor Panel Link is an interesting feature that taps on the trend of end users having a small LCD display screen as part of one's PC case to display, say, vital PC statistics or even animated videos of their choice. The said port supports a maximum display resolution of 1920 by 1080 at 30Hz. Moving back to the bottom edge of the board, we get a TPM header right here for an optional discrete Gigabyte TPM module. A noise detection header that can be used to connect the included noise detection cable so as to detect noise levels inside of the PC case, as well as a clear CMOS header. In terms of expansion slots, this board comes with a fancy looking PCIe 5.0 X16 slot for a graphics card. The said slot sports Gigabyte's PCIe UD slot X design, with a dedicated backplate as pictured to reinforce the slot, and it even comes with an inner rubber lining for the slot to protect your graphics card's PCB from scratches. As can be seen, the slot also comes with the PCIe Easy Latch Plus feature that helps make removing a graphics card from the slot less of a painful affair. We do also get a full-length PCIe 4.0 X16 slot that operates at X4 mode, and a full-length PCIe 3.0 X16 slot that operates at X4 mode. Do note that PCIe 5.0 is only supported when you have a Ryzen 9000 series or Ryzen 7000 series processor installed. It's worth noting that the Ryzen 8000 series of APUs only support the PCIe 4.0 standard. In the storage department, Gigabyte has included four SATA 3 ports, with all ports in a right-angled configuration so as to aid with cable management. For M.2 slots, it comes with three PCIe 5.0 X4 M.2 slots and one PCIe 4.0 X4 M.2 slot. Do note that all of these slots support NVMe SSDs only. M.2 SATA drives will not work in any of these slots. That's it. The M.2 heatsinks feature a toolless design called M.2 Easy Latch Click, which makes removing and installing the heatsinks really easy, like so. The PCIe 5.0 X4 M.2 slots also feature Gigabyte's UD design with a unibody stainless steel shield for improved durability and signal integrity. Another quality of life feature that the M.2 slots have is M.2 Easy Latch Plus, which makes installing and removing a M.2 drive a toolless affair like so. Now it's worth noting that with this motherboard, we do get some PCIe lane bifurcation shenanigans that are absolutely worth noting, especially if your intention is to install multiple PCIe 5.0 X4 M.2 drives on this board. Do note that the second and third PCIe 5.0 X4 M.2 slots, slots M2B_CPU and M2C_CPU, both share bandwidth with the primary PCIe 5.0 X16 slot for a graphics card, where if you have a single M.2 drive installed on any of these slots, or populate both slots for that matter with M.2 drives, the primary PCIe 5.0 X16 slot for a graphics card will operate at X8 mode instead. Again, just as a reminder, PCIe 5.0 is only supported with a Ryzen 9000 series or Ryzen 7000 series processor installed. The Ryzen 8000 series of APUs only support the PCIe 4.0 standard, and if you do have a Ryzen 8000 series APU installed on this board, do note that M.2 slots M2B_CPU and M2C_CPU will be disabled entirely. For audio, Gigabyte has included a higher-end Realtek ALC1220 audio codec with premium audio capacitors. Wired internet connectivity is courtesy of a Realtek RTL8125D chip that provides support for 2.5 gigabit Ethernet, while Wi-Fi support is courtesy of a Qualcomm QCNCM865 Wi-Fi 7 part that supports the 320 MHz channel and also serves up Bluetooth 5.3 support. In the cooling and RGB departments, the board comes with 8 fan headers that are located in these regions of the board. Also included are 3 addressable RGB headers and a single 12-volt RGB header located in these regions. Moving over to the rear I/O, the X870E AORUS Pro Ice goes for an integrated I/O shield design in white, where the said I/O shield also comes with ventilation openings like so. Now this board comes with a Qflash Plus button that allows end users to update the board's BIOS without needing to install a CPU, RAM or graphics card. 2 USB 2.0 Type-A ports, a HDMI 2.1 port that supports a maximum resolution of up to 1496 by 2160 at 60Hz. 4 USB 3.2 Gen 1 Type-A ports. 2 USB 4 Type-C ports that support the DisplayPort alternate mode with support for a maximum display resolution of 3840 by 2160 at 240Hz. 3 USB 3.2 Gen 2 Type-A ports. This port here supporting the Qflash Plus feature, a 2.5 gigabit Ethernet port, Wi-Fi antenna connectors with the new Wi-Fi Easy Plug design, and your usual audio jack connectors. To sum up, the Gigabyte X870E AORUS Pro Ice is targeted at end users who are intending to build an all-white AMD AM5 PC build at a higher end. The board sports PCIe 5.0 support for both a graphics card and M.2 drives, 2.5 gigabit Ethernet with built-in Wi-Fi 7, dual USB 4 ports, and a plethora of USB Type-C and Type-A connectivity options, alongside a whole bunch of interesting and helpful features such as sensor panel link, Easy Latch Plus, and so on. One issue worth noting is with regard to the PCIe lane bifurcation situation that I mentioned earlier on in this video, where we've got the second and third PCIe 5.0 X4 M.2 slots sharing bandwidth with the primary PCIe 5.0 X16 slot for a graphics card. Now to be fair, I do see such a similar lane bifurcation issue with other brands of X870E and X870 motherboards too. In any case, this is something to take note of, especially if your intention is to use multiple M.2 drives with this motherboard. With that, thank you so much for watching, hit the like button and get subscribed if you've enjoyed this video, and I'll catch you guys around the next time.